Hello friends and welcome to Bitfumes Angular 5 series. And in the last episode we have downloaded the Angular project, and in this episode we are going to see the structure of the Angular project we have installed. So with that, I'm your host Sarthak, and this is a channel where you will get to learn various things related to web development. And if you have not subscribed, please subscribe and like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter and Instagram. So let's see what is this. And before that, let's just start the server for our Angular project. So I will open terminal, and in the terminal I will say ng serve hyphen open and hit enter. It will open. Firstly, it will compile everything and then it will open in our Chrome browser. So we have this localhost colon 4200, and wait for some time. Yeah, here it is. So let's see how all these things are situated in our Angular app. We just have to concentrate about this source folder, because source folder is everything. So I think you know that every project starts with index.html, and so with Angular. So you have doc type, HTML heading, yeah, Angular title, that's good, and other things. But the weird part of this page, HTML page, is this app-root. What is this? This is actually an Angular component. And what is Angular component? I will just show you in just a few seconds. But obviously this is not any proper HTML tag. You can say that this is a custom HTML attribute created by the Angular. So where this is situated in our project? For that, let's go to this app directory inside our source folder. Then you will see lots of file, only 5 file, not lots of. Okay, so now if I go to app.component.ts, let's open this file, and here it's just importing component from the Angular core, and then we are setting the component details. So firstly, the selector is app-root, and this is exactly we have seen in our index.html file, exactly same. So this is coming from here. So let's do one thing. Let's select this and I will say my, that's good. If I go now, if I open console, we will get this error: app root doesn't match any element. That's good, because we are using my root and we have defined app root. So let's just change this to my root. So now let's just save this and go to Chrome, and with no time it's refreshed and again back to original state. So this means we are on the correct path. We said that this is actually the component selector name we have given. So this is good, but where all these things are situated, this means this logo, this h1 tag, this links. For that, you can see in the component the name is good, my root, but the template url, think about template url as the html part of this component where all these things are situated. So it says that it's inside same folder. This dot and this forward slash means we are looking in the same directory. So this app.component.ts in the app folder. So we are going to look for template URL in the same folder, and then the file name app.component.html, which is this app.component.html. Let's open this, and here we will see all these things are given here. So firstly, the styling something on the center, that's good. H1 tag, welcome to title. I will come back to this one. And here is actually the logo, Angular logo, this one, this logo, base 64. If I open a new tab, you can see this is a data of base 64 converted. That's nice. And now all these things, links are here. So if I say here Bitfumes blog, okay, so within no time it's changed to Bitfumes blog. Very nice. So I think you get the point that this component having the name, that means the selector, and the template URL, which is like this. But what about this curly braces and title? Welcome to title? No, it says welcome to app. So where this title came from? It's like using a variable here. It sounds like that. So let's again open app.component.ts, and you can see it says export class app component. The component, and here the title variable is assigned a string called app. So if I say welcome to Bitfumes Angular tutorials, that's very nice. And if I go and it's refreshed to welcome to Bitfumes Angular tutorials, great, awesome. So these are things you can play with Angular. But the third thing is CSS, a style URL. Just like the HTML part, we have separated, or actually Angular has separated the CSS part. So again, this is the CSS part, but it's empty. So let's just do one thing. Craziest thing, H1 tag. I'm going to color this H1 tag of green. That's nice. So save this, go here, and you can see this H1 is now having a green color. So this means for this HTML, or simply for this component, the styles are inside here. And you can do one thing more. If you have another component and you want a global style, that means style applied to each and every component in your application, then you have to go to this style.css, which is inside the source folder, src folder. If I open this, it's empty, but if I paste this, save it, and again you can see it's having a green color. This means you can either define a global CSS, or you can define a private CSS, or simply the component based CSS. That's nice. So all these things in this episode, but we will go very far for this Angular series. And if you have learned something from Bitfume and you want to support, just become the Patreon on patreon.com. You can donate $1 or more as your wish. Otherwise, you can subscribe to this channel, and don't forget to like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. We will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.